In a time before Facebook, World of Warcraft, and massive multiplayer online RPGs, there once existed simply a game. Forged by the hands of nerds, crafted in the minds of geeks, and so advanced in its advanciness, it would take five whole editions to contain all of its mighty geekery. And here, in the land of Ohio, during the year of 2021, one of the rarest types of geeks walked the earth. A dungeon master without fear or prejudice. This nerd was a girl nerd, in the most uncommon form of nerd in the world, and her name was Tilly Evans. But this story isn't about her. This story is about her sister. Agnes Evans grew up average. She was of average height, average weight, and average build. She had average parents and grew up in the average town of Athens, Ohio, with her little sister Tilly. Tilly, however, was anything but average. Though they shared the same parentage, the two young girls had very little in common. Agnes, being of average disposition, was into much more typical things, such as boys, music, and popular television programs, while her sister, Tilly, became fascinated with the dark arts, magic, dragons, and the vanquishing of pure evil.
Have you seen my phone? Miles is supposed to call me.
I left it in a shoebox on your desk.
What in the...
Be gone, loser boyfriend. You shall annoy me no more. You're welcome.
Tilly!
As average Agnes grew and grew, she became more and more engrossed with transcending her seemingly permanent state of averageness. However, frustrated by seeing her sister's unique brand of awesomeness, average Agnes made one grand wish during her junior year of high school.
I wish I didn't have such a geeky sister.
And so the gods answered her wish by smiting down her young sibling in a car crash.
No!
But fear not, adventurers. This isn't the story of that particular tragedy. No, this is the story of how Agnes the Average finally learned to fight and kill monsters. 1 year later.
Yo, what's up, my cool cats and hot hotties? It's your boy, DM Biggs, ready for all adventurers to join his newest campaign of hot demon girls, sultry she-devils, and monstrous maidens. Who's with me? Who's with me? Come on, where are you guys? Ron? Kelly? You out there?
Oh, hey.
Hi? What are you...
I'm looking for this kid who's supposed to know a lot about Dungeons and Dragons. His name is Chuck Biggs.
You're looking at him, but my homies just call me DM Biggs, because, you know, I'm big where it counts. As in, like, my brain, because, forget it. How can I help you?
I have this thingy. I'm not quite sure what it is. Do you?
It's a notebook.
I know it's a notebook. Can I send you a few pictures of it so you can get a closer look?
Sure. By the way, how'd you get my number? Not that cheerleaders having my number is a new thing, but...
Oh, it was written in here. So, did you get my text?
I did.
Do you know what this is?
It's Omspun module.
What's that?
It's like a map for a D&D game, an adventure. This one looks like it's written for 1 to 2 players at first level with entry level skills and... Hold up. Where'd you get this?
It's my sister's.
This is her sister's? Your sister is Tilius the Paladin?
Wait, you knew her?
Of course I knew her. I used to DM her campaigns.
So you can help me figure this out.
Figure it out? Why?
It's a game, Chuck. I want to play it.
Leave me hanging.
You can find a better math tutor.
You're my bestie.
Yeah, your bestie who's done trying to get you to focus.
Ugh, stupid trig. When's the last time anyone said, I'm in a jam. Hold up, let me pull out my trig real fast. Problem solved.
Hey guys.
Miles.
Vera.
What's up?
I just wanted to hop on, make sure we're still on to go to Parker's after the game.
Actually, I'm not going.
What? Why?
Doesn't have to explain herself to you. She's an independent woman. She can do whatever she wants.
Why are you a cheerleader again? I thought the cheerleaders were supposed to be cheery.
And I thought football players were supposed to have balls.
Hey!
Vera, it's okay. She's allowed to ask.
Angus, what's up? You're not breaking up with me, are you?
Yes.
No!
What is it?
It's Tilly's anniversary. I have something to do for her.
Oh.
Look, I gotta go. Sorry. See you guys later.
Nice move, Nimrod. You should have minded your own damn business.
Hello? Anyone here?
Greetings, adventurer. I am DM Biggs, known for the fact because my brain is big, no one ever gets a joke, and I will be your dungeon master for this adventure. Are you ready? Then imagine, if you will, this setting. You are standing on the sands of a mystical beachside. To one side of you is the endless ocean, and on the other, an ominous dark forest. And from the distance, a hooded stranger approaches.
Am I supposed to fight it?
No.
But you said a hooded stranger approaches. If a hooded stranger approached me in real life, I would like totally mace him.
You don't have mace here.
Can I kick him in the junk? Or do I not have feet?
Just chill. I'm still giving you your given circumstance. So, you're on a beachside with the dark forest to your right and the endless sea to your left, and then...
Welcome to Newlandia.
Tilly?
Tillius, actually, the paladin.
You're in this game? Oh my god, there's so much I need to tell you!
Stop. This is a D&D campaign, not therapy.
Sorry.
Are you sure you want to embark on this adventure, cheerleader?
Well, I don't know exactly what I'm doing, but I do know that this stuff meant a lot to you, so, right. Not therapy.
All right, cheerleader. If you really want to play, then let's play. But before we start, you're first going to have to meet the rest of our party. First up is Lilith Morningstar, class Demon Queen.
What in the pleather is she wearing?
She's our squad's muscle. Whenever you're surrounded by an armada of ogres, she's the one you want holding the steel. She's a perfect combination of both beauty and brawn.
Violence makes me hot.
Next up is Calliope Darkwalker, class Dark Elf.
Okay, seriously, does anybody wear normal clothes around here?
Along with her natural elven agility, athleticism, and ass-kicking abilities, she's also a master tracker, lockpicker, and has more than a few magical surprises up her non-existent sleeves. No pointy-eared creature has ever rocked so much lady hotness.
I'm in the mood for some danger.
And then there's...
Pause. Chuck!
Oh, yeah, what's up? This is your party.
My party is a leather-clad dominatrix and an elven supermodel.
Okay, don't look at me like that. This is directly what your sister wrote.
Violence makes me hot.
Okay, I mean, there's always a given amount of improv.
Behave yourself.
Right, right. And then Tilius the Paladin explains.
There's me. I'm the brains of this operation. Name, Tilius the Paladin, healer of the wounded, and the protector of light. Class? Awesome.
Welcome to the quest for the lost soul of Athens. Your mission is to find and free the lost soul before it is devoured by the dark forces of darkness forever.
Curious. What form of creature is this?
Are you talking about me?
Can I eat it? Lilith, you said you were quitting.
I said I'd cut down. I've only had two this week.
Cut down on what?
Eating the flesh of our enemies.
Why are you dressed so strangely?
I'm dressed strangely? You do know you look like a Comic-Con, right?
Elf.
Yes, Noble Tilius.
Have you located Orcus's whereabouts?
Wait. What's an Orcus?
Is this your special skill, asking questions?
What's your special skill? Being annoying?
Guys, stop. Orcus is a demon overlord of the underworld. If there's a lost soul, he either has it or at least knows where it is. Calliope is our tracker. If he's near, she'll know his location.
The entrance to Orcus's cave is here. But once we enter the cave, neither Lilith nor I may accompany you inside. No magical creatures are allowed in his lair unless they risk being entrapped there forever. Which means...
the only support you'll have is cheerleader Barbie here.
Yay.
And so it was. Agnes the cheerleader joined Tilius the paladin and her party in traveling into the dark, dark woods, where they would eventually find a cave entrance.
Be careful, Tilius.
If you ran into any trouble at all, remember it's okay to let the dumb one die.
You're just lovely. Do you know that?
And you would be delicious with a side of baby.
Come on, cheerleader. Let's go.
So, how scary is this demon lord?
Well, he used to sit on a throne made out of the skulls of all of his fallen enemies, so I'd say medium scary.
Okay, cool. That sounds great.
Agnes follows Tilius into Orcus's dark and dank cave.
It is moist AF in there, and it is super unpleasant.
They hear a noise deep in the cave.
And that is when you spot him.
It is I, the great paladin Tilius, healer of the wounded, defender of light, and I come here to...
Shh! We're here to battle you.
Yeah, I know. It's not gonna happen. I'm sort of busy here. It's not like this Bulbasaur is gonna catch itself. Dang it, where'd it go?
Wait. This is the Overlord of the Underworld?
Former Overworld of the Underworld. I retired.
Wait, you what? You can't retire.
But I did. You know how annoying it is to get attacked by so-called adventurers every day and night?
Orcus, it is I, the great mage Steve, and I've come to claim the staff of Saw in the name of...
Here you go, little man. It's all yours.
Really? That's all I had to do. Awesome!
So what do you two want? Treasure? Jewels? Experience points?
I want to free a soul.
Sure. Which one?
Tilius the Paladin.
Wait, what?
Wait, you're the lost soul of Athens?
You heard me, Orcus. I want my soul back.
You're Tilius.
Correct. So can I have my soul back or not?
Oh, yeah. This is a bit embarrassing. I sort of lost your lost soul.
How is that possible?
Well, I sort of traded it in for a new Switch Lite.
Who has it?
Tiamat?
Tiamat?
Who is that?
Yeah, she was really into it and I wanted to play Animal Crossing.
So you just gave my soul to her?
I mean, have you ever played Animal Crossing? It's pretty sweet.
Oh, God.
This isn't good, is it?
No, not good at all.
You Sure you don't want some treasure or jewels instead? My bad.
Hey, Agnes, where the hell were you last night?
Busy?
With Miles?
No, not with Miles.
Another man?
Sorta?
Whoa, what do you mean by sorta?
It's not what you think.
I knew this whole girl next door vibe was an act. Underneath, you're freakier than the freaks in drama club. So, who's this new hookup?
He's a freshman.
Ew, you're getting fresh with a freshman?
No, it's not like that. I'm just playing Dungeons and Dragons with him.
Say what?
Don't make a big deal out of this.
I take it back. You're not a freak. You're a geek.
Hi there. Which one of you is Vera? I'm Steve, your new math tutor.
No.
But your mom hired me to.
No.
But math.
No!
I see you're taking your education very seriously.
So how does Miles feel about his girlfriend going geek?
He doesn't?
Oh, so just another thing he doesn't know about you. Surprise, surprise.
Why don't you like him?
He's a player.
He's not a player.
Please, he's a jock. He plays.
Can we please change subjects?
So what's up with this game? Is it some sort of senioritis crisis?
I know it's stupid. It's just, I want to know why she liked it so much.
Right, sorry. So how is it?
Honestly, it's kind of weird.
How?
You're not serious about this love. Do you really want to bring Arcus along?
I must agree with Lilith. Having the worst demon in all the underworld accompany us seems quite illogical.
I concur. Look at me. I'm totes evil.
No, you're coming with us.
Oh man, and I was in the middle of a Game of Thrones marathon.
You lost my soul, Arcus. Now you're going to help me get it back.
He holds knowledge regarding your lost soul?
He gave it to Tiamat.
What?
Hello, what's a Tiamat?
Calliope, you tell her.
This is Tiamat. She's a five-headed dragon that has laid waste to generations of adventurers and civilizations since the dawn. Each of her heads embody the five different elemental powers of chronomic dragons. Earth, fire, water, wind, and lightning. She can fly, she can breathe fire, she can also shape change. Many adventurers have fought her. All have died, except for one.
Holy crap, Tilly! You fought that? That's like totally awesome!
Useless. I didn't pull off killing her. I just wounded her in the belly. And now she's stolen my soul for her revenge.
And you, Arcus, just gave it away?
Arcus, tell us the location of Tiamat now!
Fine. Go Orcus map. Behold my comically detailed map of Newlandia. This is the path you have to take if you want to face Tiamat. First, you must travel down the River of Wetness to the Swamps of Mushy.
The names of these locations are terrible.
I was going to go back and give them better names later, but, you know, I sort of died before I could get to it.
Then you will climb the Mountain of Steepness to the Castle of Evil, where you will find Tiamat.
Seems simple enough.
But to be able to face Tiamat, you'll have to face her three guardians, who are all totally badass, so most likely one, if not all of you, are gonna die.
That sounds less simple.
My friends, I cannot ask all of you to come with me. The journey before us is too perilous. and the prize too personal for me to expect you to risk your lives.
Tilius, you know as always that you will always have my blade.
And mine.
Seriously, I'm fine with just chilling.
You don't get a choice.
Man.
What about you, Agnes? What say you?
She's my sister. Well, you're my sister. Of course I'm in.
Good. Then let us kick it some ass.
And so our team of adventurers set forth into the wild, following the path Porcus traced out for them. It was indeed treacherous, and they did indeed kicketh ass.
Aw, look, it's a forest fairy. Hey there, fairy, how are you?
Fairy reaches out, puts Orcus in an armbar.
Ow, what are you doing?
Did I give you consent to talk to me, you big bowl of stupid?
She punches Orcus directly in the stomach.
Ow!
Now get out of my magically enchanted forest before I go fairy berserker all over your ugly butts.
I thought fairies were supposed to be nice.
Nice? Do I sound like a hobbit to you? Ain't no one gonna be nice all the damn time. Fairies are happy. Happy. No one said anything about nice.
Maybe we should just take the long way around to the Mountain of Steepness.
Yo, hold up. You five are going to the Mountain of Steepness?
Does that change anything?
Maybe it does.
Then maybe we are.
So you're not lost at all. You meant to come here. You mean to...
Fight Tiamat.
Vanquish the dragon.
And save my soul. Oh,
yeah,
damn.
You're kind of a big deal.
Sorry, I didn't know all that. You should have just said something straight up.
So, we cool?
Sure, we're cool. I mean, now I have to murder the crap out of all of you, but we're totally cool.
Wait, say what?
I'm one of the great guardians, dummy. Prepare to die.
She is, but we. What could she possibly do?
It is I, the great mage Steve, and I've come to...
Fairy reaches out and rips out Steve's throat.
Oh God.
To hell with that. That girl is straight up cray cray.
If you want to get to Tiamat, you're going to have to go through me first. Fine by me.
Boss fight number one. Farrah the Fairy versus Team Tilius. You all pull out your weapons and charge.
And...
Yeah, she pretty much kicks the crap out of all of you.
Who's your fairy?
Our skills are no match.
We need magic, real magic, to defeat her.
What magic?
I call on Magic Missile.
Tilly casts Magic Missile.
Oh no.
A magical ball of energy rockets out of Tilius's hands towards Farrah until boom! She is defeated.
Yes!
Agnes. There's something I want to tell you. It's I love you.
Oh, hey.
Oh, hey! What are you doing here?
I am looking for Agnes. What are you doing here?
Yeah, I was looking for her as well.
Cool.
Wait, who are you?
Oh, yeah, sorry. I'm Chuck. I'm Agnes's DM. And you are?
You're what?
Oh, right. Sorry. I'm not supposed to talk about that. I'm her friend. Her secret friend.
My girlfriend's secret friend?
And you are?
Her boyfriend.
Really? Oh, huh. I didn't know she was dating anyone.
She didn't tell you about me?
Well, that's probably my fault. I keep her pretty busy, if you know what I mean.
Doing what?
Fighting monsters, my man. Fighting monsters.
I don't even know what that means. But I do know it makes me want to kick your ass!
Why?
Because she's my girlfriend!
Oh, no, man. It ain't like that.
No, what's it like, man, huh?
We just roleplay.
What?!
Yeah, I'm just here to help her play out this fantasy, alright? It's just for fun. I got no feelings for her.
I'm gonna break you in half.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Oh, hi.
What are you doing here?
I should go.
Why?
Well, you're clearly busy, huh?
Oh, God. You know about this now, don't you?
Yeah, I'd say so.
You don't think I'm a dork now, do you?
No, that's not what I'm thinking.
Well, do you want to talk about it?
No.
Man, that guy really hates D&D.
Tilius, the way you risked yourself in that last battle, though noble, could have cost you your life. And for what?
This is who I am. I'm tired of holding back.
But why risk so much?
Because you were in danger. That's why.
Oh.
I love you.
Wait, you what?
Oh, hey there, Agnes.
What are you two doing?
I was just professing my love to my girlfriend. Why?
You two are a couple?
Does that upset you, Lunchmeat?
It upsets me that you only wear black. What is happening here?
I told you, we're lovers.
You're gay?
Does that matter?
Whoa, looks like I'm not the only monster here.
I never took you for a homophobe.
I am not a homophobe.
That's not what it looks like to me.
I watch Queer Eye. There's no way I'm anti-gay.
Then what's your problem?
You love her?
Yeah, what's the big deal?
I just thought I knew you. At least well enough to know whether you dug boys or girls.
You were busy.
Not too busy to know this. Tilly, I'm your sister. I shouldn't have to learn about you through a role-playing game.
Well, don't worry. You haven't learned anything about me just yet.
What's that supposed to mean?
Tilius is a guy character.
What?
Tilius is a guy.
But she doesn't look like a guy.
Well, that's because you're imagining your sister's character as your actual little sister. But when Tilly played the game, she thought of herself as some dude named Tilius, who's a guy.
Why would she do that?
I don't know. Why do dudes always play hot girls in fighting games? I guess it's a thing.
So, does this mean Tilly's not...
Maybe you should just get back to the game and not really worry about all that stuff. It's not really part of the adventure.
Oh, okay. Where were we?
Lilith, Calliope, Orcus, where are they?
Agnes looks around and spots the rest of the party lying down in a meadow.
they're right over there, taking a nap.
Demons and elves don't sleep.
They don't? Then why are they unconscious right now?
Boom goes the dynamite.
As if. Oh, crap.
What?
Succubi.
Succubi?
Succubi. Demon cheerleaders from the demon world that totally suck.
Are they one of Tiamat's guardians?
No, they're just really mean. Let's go.
Not so fast there, nerd.
Hey, guys, what's up?
Were you looking at us?
No, not specifically. I was just looking, you know, in your general direction. And then you step into my line of fleeing.
I think she's lying.
I hate liars.
I'm not lying.
Hey, what are you guys doing?
One of the succubi reaches out and grabs you by the throat. You're helpless to resist her.
What in the hell?
Let her go!
I think the reason why she was looking at you, Evil Tyler, is because she has the hots for you.
That's not true!
Are you saying I'm ugly?
No!
Then you do think I'm cute. I don't understand. I don't speak.
The succubi bears down on your throat even harder.
Ow!
I don't speak ow either.
No, I do. I think you're so cute. You're so cute.
Of course you think she's pretty, you dyke.
Sorry, Evil Tyler. He's just really sensitive about his looks.
Shut up, Evil Gabby.
She doesn't mean to be mean to you. I like you. I do. Look, do you want to join our club?
Again with the us.
Ow!
I would love to join.
Cool. All you have to do to become a member is tell me. Who would you rather hook up with? Me or Evil Tyler?
What?
Which one of us do you find hotter?
I don't know.
Evil Tyler. Kill the sister.
No, I would rather hook up with you.
See? I knew she was gay.
She's so in love with you.
Agnes fights free.
Hey, leave her alone. You two are going to die, so help me.
Well, see you around, lesbians.
Hey, are you okay?
No.
Chuck! I thought Eustatilius was a guy.
He is.
Then why would her character get picked on like that?
Look, I'm no Yoda, but I don't think this module is just a game. I think this is actually your sister's diary. She just wrote it in Geek.
Vera! Yo, Vera, we need to talk. Vera! What are you doing here?
What do you mean?
Why are you here?
I'm waiting for Vera. I'm her new math tutor.
Hold up. Wait, you're real?
Huh?
Oh, sorry. That must sound crazy.
No, not at all.
Sorry, I'm Agnes.
I know who you are.
You do?
You don't remember, but we've actually met before. I knew your sister. I mean, we were in the same class. I met you at her...
Oh, right. Yeah, her whole class came out.
She was awesome. She was really, like, the best person I ever knew. I'm Lily, by the way. Tilly and I were in band together and...
Wait. Your name's actually Lily, as in Lilith?
It's actually short for Elizabeth.
So this was real.
What was real?
You and Tilly. You two were real.
I'm not following.
You two dated.
What? No.
Of course.
I didn't date Tilly. I like boys, I swear.
God, this explains so much. You two were together.
I'm not gay.
It's okay. You can tell me.
It's not true. It's not true.
Hey, what's with all the excitement?
This is Tilly's girlfriend.
No, I'm not.
You know what? You should go. I'm so sorry. My friend here has this brain thingy. It makes her sound crazy. You should go before she starts with the mouth foaming and the biting. What the hell is wrong with you?
That was Tilly's girlfriend.
Okay, one, chill. Two, even if she was, you screaming you're a lesbo at her isn't the best way to coax her out of the closet.
She might be the only link I have left.
I know, but look at me. Whoever that girl is, she's still just some 15-year-old girl growing up in the middle of Athens, Ohio. If that girl's in the closet, she's going to be in there deep.
Hey.
Hey.
What happened back there with the evil cheerostitutes?
What did it look like?
Did that sort of stuff really happen? I mean, in real life?
I was a dorky 15-year-old girl who loved D&D. What do you think?
So how come you had to make up a game to tell me all this?
I didn't want to tell you all of this, if that's what you're wondering. This game was supposed to be private, remember?
I met Lily, the real one.
Oh, yeah?
She's gay, isn't she?
Maybe, I guess.
Are you gay?
I don't know.
Tilly, you can talk to me.
I'm not really her, you know?
What?
Hi, yeah, it's me. I can extrapolate pretty far, but this is feeling a bit blasphemous.
I was talking to my sister. Do you mind?
Agnes, look, I am all for role-playing, but this is much deeper than I usually get.
Play the role, Chuck.
But, Agnes...
Play it!
Okay, look, there's something in Tilly's notebook that I think you should see.
Do it in character.
Agnes...
Do it!
Agnes...
Can you do me a favor?
What?
I wrote something for Lily in my notebook. Can you give it to her?
Please.
Hey, can I talk to you for a minute?
What are you doing here?
I need advice.
And I need a passing grade in trig.
Look, Dad, you're one of my best friends.
No, I'm your girlfriend's best friend. It's different.
So is she going to dump me?
Hi there, it's me again. Lily said she couldn't tutor you, so she asked me to do it.
Look. Angus is cheating on me with a freshman.
Steven, just ignore him. He'll eventually go away. Forever.
I'm not going away!
So you know a lot about trick.
So you're fine with your best friend just, you know, fooling around with a freshman?
Excuse me. You want some advice, Miles? Break up with her.
Really?
Yes, really. Be honest with me, Miles. You don't care about her. You only care that she's a cheerleader and you're a jock and it fits within your two-dimensional high school experience.
That's not true.
Then how come you haven't dropped the L-bomb yet?
The lesbian bomb?
Love bomb, you idiots! You've been together a year and a half and all you've said so far is, I really, really like you, babe. That girl deserves so much better than some dumb football jock.
I'm also class president.
Whatever. You're still just some dude, and she's Agnes. My Agnes. Your resume has got to be far more impressive than a few high school extracurriculars to impress me.
You don't think I appreciate her?
Not really.
So you think I'm here just getting attacked by you because I think she's cute? Are you high? Of course I am. L-bomber. Jesus, Vera. She lost her sister last year. She's got other things on her mind than me. I've just been taking it slow for her. You're not the only person in the world who wants to protect her. But you know, it doesn't matter either way now because she's dating a freshman.
Miles, she's not dating a freshman. That kid's just her dungeon master.
He brings her to a dungeon?
No. He's a D&D dork. He's like the guy who rolls the dice and whatever.
Why is she playing D&D?
Well, maybe you should ask her. What's wrong, Agnes? By the droop of your shoulders and your downward gaze, it would indicate you are troubled somehow.
Wow, you're observant.
Was that sarcasm?
No.
My apologies, Agnes. We elves may have heightened speed, agility, and strength, but...
Don't forget modesty.
We lack emotional awareness?
So you're like a robot?
We're elves. We're above emotions. That's a human trait.
Well, color me envious.
What troubles you?
I joined this adventure to get to know my sister, to help her. But I don't think she needs me at all.
Well, I don't think she needs help from most people. She is a 20th level paladin, after all. If anything, we travel with her because we often require her help.
Wow, Elf. You're really bad at giving advice.
My apologies. Would you like to make out now?
Wait, what?
I think it would make you feel better. I hear humans like to do such things.
Chuck! I am not going to fool around with the elf girl.
What? I don't want to see you get sexy with the sexy elf girl. Why would anyone want to hear you describe that? Gross.
Can we get back to the actual quest, please?
Sorry. Fine. You return back to your party after not hooking up with Calliope. When you spot...
Wait, what is that?
That, my dear human friend, is boss number 2. Miles the gelatinous cube.
Wait, what?
It is I, the great mage Steve. Oh neat, a jello mold.
Steve is sucked into the gelatinous cube and dissolves into bone and dust.
Aw, man. Really?
Wait, you made my boyfriend a jello mold?
What? No.
You actually did.
The elf is correct, love. You indeed made Agnes's love companion into a big cube of demonic gelatin.
So hold up, that thing isn't edible?
No.
Aw, man, and I had the munchies.
Why did you make Miles a flesh-eating jello mold?
Maybe because he sucks.
I thought you liked him.
Yeah, I loved watching you two make out every day in our living room over Coldplay.
We never listened to Coldplay. It was Shawn Mendes.
Oh, sorry. That's clearly so much less lame.
Tilius, though I find you mocking your sister incredibly sexy, shouldn't we, you know, kill this thing before it kills us?
You're right. Let's kill Miles.
No!
And once again, you're choosing your boyfriend over me.
Your boyfriend is a gelatinous cube?
Gross.
That's not fair, Tilly, and you know it.
And I thought you were here to save my soul. I guess you didn't mean it. Quest is over, guys. We lost. The last adventure I will ever take ends in a forfeit.
Stop.
Why? So I can watch you run off with Slimy McSlimer face and forget all about me?
I would never forget about you.
You did when I was alive.
Oh, snap. She went there.
So, are we giving up or what?
Fine. Whatever. It's clearly not my boyfriend, right? You just named him that. Miles isn't actually green, slimy, and cube-shaped.
Are we going to kill it or not?
We're gonna fight it.
Really?
Really.
All right. You hear that, Miles? We're gonna kill the crap out of you.
But can we not call it Miles?
Sure. We don't have to call it Miles.
Suddenly, the gelatinous cube magically transforms into the shape of a human. Not just any human. It's Miles. But dressed in a barbarian costume.
Sup, babe?
What the hell?
Oh, I don't think boss number two is actually a gelatinous cube.
It's a shapeshifter.
A doppelganger, to be exact.
Go kill it, sis. Yes.
Boss fight number two. Agnes the cheerleader versus Miles the doppelganger.
You're not actually him. You're not actually him.
Miles strikes Agnes.
Ow!
Don't take this personal.
This is not fair, Tilly.
It's a boss. It's not supposed to be fair.
You're not actually Miles.
Don't tell me who I am!
Miles attacks Agnes again. Ooh, big damage.
Ow! Seriously, are you guys not going to help?
Really, none of my business.
No, not really.
You guys suck.
Speaking on that subject.
Just a minute, asshole. I don't care who you look like. Nobody disrespects me. I attack him.
You cut Miles directly across the chest.
Oh, now you made me angry! I attack!
I block with my shield, but immediately counter with a slash at his torso.
Okay. Strike lands.
Ah!
He yelps in pain.
As he does, I drive my sword at
his heart.
His crotch.
The attack lands. He's been, yep, circumcised.
No! Not
the pain
again!
Is too much. Miles falls unconscious and bleeds out. He dies. You just beat the second boss.
Oh, man. I was just starting to like the guy. Too bad.
Hello, Agnes.
Hi, Agnes.
Huh?
Do you have a moment?
Just one free second?
Okay, sure. What's up?
I'm Tyler.
And I'm Gabby.
And we're both on this year's yearbook committee representing the freshman class. And we were wondering if we could be okay with you if we ran an ad in this year's Bobcat Annual.
Why would I care what you do?
It's not an ad for us, silly.
It's just by us.
For Tilly.
You want to make an ad for Tilly.
We want her to know.
Wherever she is.
She will always be a part of the class of 2024.
So you were friends.
Totally.
She was such a good spirit.
She always lit up a room.
Is that right?
We admire her.
Just like we admire you. We're also fellow cheerleaders.
I mean, we're freshmen and you're on the varsity squad, but we're all fellow Bobcats.
Go Bobcats! Bobcats!
We're practically sisters.
Sisters? You think you're my sister? I have a sister, and you're not her. Now get out of my face, you evil, stupid little assholes, before I kick your ass.
Okay.
Sorry.
That seemed really effective.
What am I supposed to do, Tilly? I can't just beat them up.
I would've.
Am I going crazy?
At least you're not dead.
Okay, here we go. You and your party are making your way through the forest atop the mountain of steepness. It's hard and treacherous terrain. But as you make it over the next ridge, you suddenly run into...
What's up, guys?
Your boyfriend?
Hey.
Am I interrupting anything?
Well, sorta.
Were you guys, playing Dungeons & Dragons?
We weren't playing tonsil hockey, if that's what you were wondering.
That was an option?
No.
Vera told you, huh?
She's my best friend. Of course she told me.
So I misinterpreted the situation. Are you mad at me?
I'm not happy.
Okay, that's fair, but you're not mad.
Keep asking me that question and see what happens.
Well, I came by because I thought maybe, we could, hang out.
I'm busy.
All right, then how about tomorrow? Can you hang out tomorrow?
I don't know.
I thought you said you were mad.
I'm not mad. I'm just focused on this right now.
Agnes, come on.
I'm not in the mood to...
Hey, man. You want to join in?
What?
I mean, if you want to hang out, you guys could both do this. Can't be any worse than Agnes, right?
No, he doesn't want to play.
Actually, I would. I would like to play, Chuck.
What are you doing?
This is important to you, so I want to be a part of it.
It's private, though.
I know, but you never talk to me about Tilly. About anything important, I just... If this could help me get to know you better, I want to try. Please?
Fine. Send him a character sheet, Chuck.
Alrighty. You will be Miles the Bard.
Well, what's a bard?
Don't worry, they're cool. Okay, so you make it over a ridge and...
Agnes, look out!
Boss number two!
No. This is not boss number two. This is Miles. The actual Miles. My boyfriend.
What's he doing here?
He wanted to come along.
We already have 5 people in our party. We're full.
So this is Dungeons and Dragons, huh? Neat.
Can I eat him? He looks... meaty.
You can't be serious, Agnes.
Look, you might not like him, but he has my back.
We have your back?
Right. Just like you had my back when you made me kill my boyfriend.
Oh, what? You killed me?
I killed a big fat blob that looked like you.
What? I look like a big fat blob?
If you got into trouble, we would have stepped in.
Assuredly.
I wouldn't have.
No way.
Guys, you're not helping.
So what's the next thing we have to fight?
The next boss is a beholder.
Aw, that sounds cute. Like beauty is in the eye of the beholder.
No.
That thing is ugly.
Like just one big scary eyeball with teeth.
Listen, guess. It's all right, I got you. I'm a bard. What?
Oh my god, Evil Talon, look! An impenetrable wall of losers!
How will we ever get past them?
Ooh, cheerleaders.
Do not engage.
Why?
They'll kill you, that's why!
Gus, they're just cheerleaders. What are they going to do?
They rip out Miles's heart.
What?
He's dead.
No!
Well, that didn't last long.
Oh, Evil Tyler, how hungry are you?
Starving.
What would you like first, light or dark meat?
I'm in the mood for geek.
There's only one way we can get out of this situation.
And that would be?
With violence, love. Lots and lots of violence.
Lilith, no.
I love you, Tilius.
Lilith charges the succubi.
Don't.
Lilith attacks and they... Oh, no.
What? What happened?
They kill her.
No!
Aw, look at the little nerd girl.
Sad nerd girl.
Don't worry, Dyke. Your pain is about to end, too.
Succubi focus on Tilly. They raise their weapons and prepare to strike.
I step in the way.
What?
I join her.
So does Orcus.
What? Really? I do?
You do.
Okay, I join too, I guess.
I don't see what's so funny.
You're about to die.
Prepare to be ushered to your death.
You can't beat us.
We're way too powerful for you.
Who said we were going to do it with our fists? Enough with all this dorky D&D stuff. You really think you're badasses? Then let's finish this. Cheerleader style. We challenge you to a dance battle.
Bonus round. Agnes, the elf, and Orcus versus the evil succubi cheerleaders in a dance battle. Suddenly, Agnes, Calliope, and Orcus appear and stab the succubi in their backs.
What? No fair.
You cheated!
What? You really thought we were going to dance battle you to death? Wow, I guess my sister's right. Cheerleaders are dumb.
The succubi are dead.
No!
Oh!
Tilly? Tilly, are you okay?
She's gone. Lilith is really gone.
No. We'll get her back.
How?
You're magical. Do something.
I don't have that kind of magic.
Orcus?
I only keep souls. I don't bring them back.
Chuck, you're the DM. Resurrect her. Now.
I rolled the dice. It says she died.
Throw the dice. Just do it.
Not for this adventure. There's rules.
Look, I don't care what the rules are. Just bring her back.
Hey, babe. Maybe you should take a breather. I just died. I'm fine.
No, I'm not going to let my sister suffer like this again.
She's not actually your sister.
Screw you.
Hey.
Are you going to fix this, Chuck? Are you?
I'm sorry.
No!
Babe!
Go away!
Agnes!
I was just getting to know her.
Getting to know who, babe?
Tilly.
Her character's not dead.
But she is. This is stupid. She's dead. None of this matters.
Agnes?
Chuck?
Agnes?
I'm done.
What?
Thank you so much for indulging me. I'll call you if I change my mind, but I'm done talking to ghosts. Goodbye.
Hey, Miles said you had a bit of a meltdown.
Miles needs to mind his own business.
What's up? Girl, it's me. I'm not your stupid boyfriend. You can talk to me.
It's just, that game was all I had of her.
Come on, you know that's not true. You have memories.
My memories? My memories are shit. Do you want to know what my memories of Tilly are? They're of this little nerdy girl who I never talked to, who I ignored, who I didn't understand because she lived in a different world than I did. Her world was filled with evil jello molds and demon queens, while mine had cute haircuts and pep rallies. I didn't get her. I assumed I would one day, that she'd grow out of all this, that I'd be able to sit around and ask her about normal things like clothes and TV shows and boys. And as it turns out, no one can even tell me if she was into boys or not.
It's okay, Agnes.
But no, it's not. I didn't know her, Vera. I remember her as a baby. I remember her as this little toddler I loved picking up and holding, but I don't remember her as a teen at all. And I'll never get the chance to know her as an adult. And now all I have left is this stupid notebook and this stupid made-up adventure about killing a stupid made-up dragon. It just all infinitely sucks.
Hey, sorry to interrupt. Agnes, do you have a moment?
I'm not going back to the game.
No, it's not that. I was also wondering if you were free this afternoon.
What? Are you asking me out?
I can do that?
She was being sarcastic, dummy.
What is it?
I just wanted to show you something. Something of Tilly's.
Yo, what's up, Home Slice? What are you doing here?
Orcus?
Actually, this is Ronnie.
Hey, wow, a senior girl talking to me. Sweet.
I just wanted you to meet some of Tilly's friends. Ronnie, this is who I was telling you about.
Whoa, you're Tilly's sister?
Yep.
Man, you are very attractive.
Ronnie, outside voice, bud.
I'm saying stuff out loud that I should keep in my head, right? My bad.
Is your sister around?
Let me get her. Wait just 1 minute.
Sorry to bug you.
Ah, it's all right. I was just marathoning Battlestar.
Kelly, hey, what are you doing?
You really didn't do much to make him different.
This is a picture of his sister.
Wait, Calliope?
Kelly.
Wow, is she actually hotter in real life? How come I never noticed her at school?
Well...
Okay, she'll be right on. I had to start up her computer for her.
Why would you need to do that?
Hey guys, sorry, here I am. Who's this?
This is Tilly's sister.
Oh, hi, nice to meet you. It's CP. It just affects my legs, though. The rest of me's fine.
Oh, God, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to.
It's okay. I'm used to it.
So, you play D&D with these guys?
Yeah, dorky, right?
No, not dorky at all.
Your sister was awesome, Agnes. We loved her. We really miss her.
Yeah, me too.
What are you doing?
I'm getting to know your friends.
Are you judging them?
No.
I know they're geeky. I'm geeky. We're all geeks.
Why do you think I care about that stuff?
Everyone else does, or did. I mean, until I got run over by a truck and then suddenly, wow, I'm the most popular girl in school.
Is that why all you guys play this?
No, we play it because it's awesome. It's about adventures and saving the world and having magic. And maybe, I guess, in some small way, some small teeny capacity. It might have a little to do with wish fulfillment. Kelly gets to run, Ronnie gets to be super strong.
What about you?
Me? I get to save the princess.
Oh, hi. Can we talk? I promise I'm not going to do anything crazy.
Okay.
Look, I'm sorry about freaking out the other day, but I know you're not gay or was my sister's whatever, but she wanted me to give you something.
What?
I left it with your brother. He said he'd put it in your room. It's from Tilly.
What does it say?
Well, I don't know. It wasn't addressed to me.
Thank you.
Have a good day.
Wait. I did know Tilly.
Oh, I know. You were at her funeral.
No, I mean, like, we were close. Real close. I mean, Tilly wasn't my girlfriend, but she was the only person I was truly open with.
You mean?
Yeah, that's what I mean.
So was she?
Does it matter?
No, I guess not.
She was my hero, Agnes. She saved me. Maybe we could have been something more, but it's all too late now. I did love her. I wish I could have told her.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Thank you, Agnes.
Okay, Chuck, I get it. I really do. Let's finish this.
Boss number 3. Vera, the Beholder.
Puny adventurers, you have no hope to defeat me. I am a...
I throw my dagger at it.
Oh. You just killed the beholder.
What? Man, this is bullshit.
Okay, so where's this dragon Tiamat? This is the right castle of evil, right?
Yes, it's the right castle.
So, where is it?
Well, Agnes, there's something I should remind you about Tiamat.
What?
She's a shapeshifter.
Like Miles, the gelatinous cube.
It can take any form.
A friend.
A lover.
Anyone.
It is I, the great mage Steve.
I throw my dagger at him.
Gets impaled into his skull and he dies immediately.
Man!
Oh, wait. So he's not the dragon?
Nope.
If he's not, then who is?
I don't know, love. Where could you possibly find a monster in this game?
Lilith?
I mean, look around. Where, oh, where could all of the monsters possibly be?
Watch out, Agnes. There's a demon.
A dark elf.
A demon queen.
Tiamat.
What? You didn't actually think I was a paladin, did you? Everyone knows paladins can't shoot magic missiles.
Tilly, what's happening?
What do you think is happening, big sis? This is a D&D adventure, and what would a D&D adventure be if you didn't get to fight a dragon?
Tilly? Calliope? Orcus? Anyone?
Final fight. Agnes versus Tiamat.
Oh, God! I attack.
No damage.
I attack again.
No damage.
Attack!
Nothing.
What?
Your character is just not strong enough. There's no way you can beat her.
No, you're wrong.
Okay, this isn't gonna work.
No, but I didn't come all this way to fail her again. I'm getting my sister's soul back, and there's nothing in this world, in this universe, that's going to stop me. She's my sister, and I love her. So roll that dice and keep rolling it, because this monster, I'm killing it.
That's what you want.
I attack.
Okay, you strike it.
I attack again.
That strike also lands.
I keep attacking again and again and again.
This is crazy. These are all critical hits you're landing. I've never seen anything like this. You look up. And you see a weak spot on its belly, the one the real Tilius had given it years before.
I plunge my sword into Tiamat's gut.
You did it. Holy crap, you actually did it. Tiamat has fallen. You won back the lost soul of Athens.
Job, sis.
Billy?
Did you have fun?
What?
Did you have fun? That's the point in all this. Did you have fun? Good.
Wait, you're dead. You're gone.
I know, but this story remains. And isn't that essentially what life is? A collection of stories? This was one of mine.
Not just some story I experienced, like a party or a dance, but something I dreamt.
Something far more impersonal and important than happenstance. This story came from my soul, and by breathing life into it, who knows?
Maybe a bit of my soul gets the chance to breathe for a moment once again.
I love you, my sister.
I'm sorry I can't be there.
I have no idea why you had to experience this adventure alone without me, but I hope it gave you a glimpse into me the way I wanted you to see me.
Strong.
Powerful.
And magical.
Congratulations. You have finished the quest for the lost soul of Athens.
And so, Agnes the cheerleader accomplished her very first quest. Soon she would embark on another, and another, and another, and so on and so forth for the rest of her life. Miles the boyfriend, who would one day become Miles the ex-boyfriend, would join her on her many quests, alongside Chuck the big brain and Tilly's old group of friends, Ronnie the slacker, Kelly the not-so-good-legged, Lily the closeted. Tilly was never forgotten. Agnes grew up, and she always remembered fondly the day she killed monsters.
The end.